Hi, in this video, we move away from the theory of Boolean logic as we dig into a new fundamental programming construct, the while loop. While loops are challenging to understand when you see them for the first time, so don't worry if you haven't mastered them after the first example. To motivate the need for this new thing, the while loop, I'd like to revisit this diagram. Recall that an if statement allows you to do something unless a condition is false. If the condition is false, nothing gets printed. What if you want to do something until a condition becomes false? Okay, let's look at an actual program where that might be useful. Imagine you wrote a program that allows someone to try to guess a number. If they guess incorrectly, they don't get to try again. At the top on the right, you can see what the code for this program might look like. Now, instead of just giving the user a single guess, what if we want to let the user keep guessing until they guess correctly? We can do that with a while loop.
Cow.
A while loop is a programming construct that allows you to repeatedly check a condition and execute code. Before we fix the guess the number program, let's look at a simpler program. The behavior of this program is fairly straightforward. Set a variable to 5, compare it against 0, and finally, print it and decrement it if it was greater than 0. What if we want to keep printing until the variable reaches 0? We do this with a while loop. A while loop acts like a repeated if statement. When the body of a while loop is executed, the Python interpreter jumps back to the condition to check if the body should be executed again. Here's what a while loop looks like. It looks a lot like an if statement. The only difference is the word while in the place of the word if. The condition still has to be something that evaluates to a Boolean. The code under the while loop is the body. If the condition is true, it executes. Every time it executes, the condition is checked again. Unless the condition has become false, the body runs again. And guess what? Everything in the body of the while loop has to be indented by one level. Let's trace through this program line by line. Where's our interpreter? There it is. We'll use a little box to represent the variable my number. The first line sets this variable to 5. The interpreter checks the condition. Since 5 is greater than 0, the condition is true, so the interpreter will continue the body of the loop. The value of my number gets printed, and then the value of my number changes to 4. Here's the weird thing about a while loop. It isn't finished when the last line of the body has run. What happens is the interpreter goes back to the top and evaluates the condition again, as though it were seeing it for the first time. Since 4 is greater than 0, the condition is true once again, so the interpreter moves to the first line of the body. 4 is printed, and the value of my number is changed to 3. We loop back to the top. 3 is greater than 0, the condition is true. 3 gets printed, my number becomes 2. Back to the top. 2 is greater than 0. Print 2, change my number to 1, back to the top. 1 is greater than 0, print 1, change my number to 0, back to the top. Now, 0 is not greater than 0, so the condition is false. Once the condition becomes false, the Python interpreter skips over the rest of the while loop and continues on to the rest of the program. Okay, now let's revisit that guess my number program. At the right, you will see a first incorrect attempt at changing the program to use a while loop. Watch what happens when we step through this line by line. My number gets set to 10, we ask the user for a number, they type 23, and we compare that to 10. They are unequal, which means the condition is true. So the print gets executed. We go back to the top and reevaluate the condition, and nothing has changed, so it's still true. So we print again. You can see where this is going. The user never gets a chance to enter a new number. It is important to make sure that the condition has a chance to change during the while loop. If you don't, you may end up with what is called an infinite loop. These are bad. Now, before the while condition is reevaluated, the variable guess has a chance to change. This means that the condition might have a different truth value than before. In other words, each time we get to the top of the while loop, while guess may not have been equal to my number before, it might be equal this time. As one final touch, we can add a print statement at the end of the program. Notice that we don't need to check anything before printing. If the final print statement is reached, that means that the condition in the while loop must have been false. This means guess is not equal to my number, which means it is equal to my number. All right, one quick note. Even if condition becomes false in the middle of the loop, it doesn't get checked again until the body of the loop is finished. In this program, the first print runs, then x becomes 0, which will eventually mean the condition of the while loop will be false. However, since this isn't checked until the interpreter returns to the top of the loop, the second print runs as well. Then the interpreter returns to the top, and since the condition is false, the loop is over.